Hello, hello, hello. It's been a while and should have been done ages ago, but at last I've come around and done the blasphemous combination of combining hypersonic towers plus modded 5th tier towers courtesy of Jambite. I don't know why I didn't do this months ago, cause it seemed like a no-brainer with hypersonic towers being a signature of mine, but oh well, you guys should know the drill for these kinds of videos. Sandbox mode, mad damage, lots of projectiles, and lots of lag. One thing I have to note though, unlike the previous tower showcases, I haven't brought along the village, which you might find weird since the call to arms stacking is the only reason hypersonic towers exist in the first place. And yes, it is indeed weird, but I was lazy to mod them into here because there was another way I could achieve close to what I was getting with the village stacking without having to do any work on my own. And well, the answer is right over here on this boost button, which Jambite modded to give you infinite boosts with pretty much zero cooldown between them. This gives you the hyperspeed towers on top of a pretty dank green aura surrounding the tower for a good 10 seconds. The only thing you sacrifice is the infinite popping power, because boosts only affect the attack speed. Nonetheless, I guess we've already started the showcase, going in order of my loadout at the bottom with Dark Monkey, Tack Shooter, Sniper, and finally the Ninja. These 8 upgrades should hopefully be enough content for this one. My honest goal is to stretch this out into as many videos as possible, because I don't want to start having to make BTD 2 throwback videos as a result of running out of ideas. Anyways, the left-sided 5th tier Dark Monkey is already a hypersonic tower without having to use any hypersonic boosts, lol. This is probably the most boring upgrades to overcharge with, that said. It's not completely useless power-wise, however, it's pretty hard to notice, but the hypersonic juggernaut upgrade does indeed shoot out their spikes faster if you use the boost, but it hits the speed cap pretty fast, so those 6 or so boosts I'm using isn't of much use aside from looking pretty. I think that's all we really need to see here, so let's head on over to the right side 5th tier, which is basically a Super Monkey fan club, but with Sun Gods instead of OP00 Super Monkeys. I may have lied when I said the Juggernaut upgrade is the most boring to overcharge, cause this one is pretty close to that as well. Just know that if a tower is already shooting super duper fast without boosts, it ain't going to be much different with a boost included. I mean, I can barely tell a difference over here right now. The speed the Sun Gods are shooting at pretty much looks the same as your usual Sun God, but I guess it's just cool to see mass destruction regardless. Let's move on, shall we? I've seen enough of the Dart Monkey at this point. So the 5th tier Tack Shooter is an interesting one. If you haven't seen it yet, then let me explain it to you, or just take a look. It's a ring of fire that shoots out approximately 64 other rings of fire, and I'm pretty sure they do multiple layers of damage each, cause they absolutely demolish any balloon upon arrival even without the boost. Classic 5th tier towers. Times like these is where it's probably useful if I modded the game to give blimps 10 times more health, cause it's more fun when they don't always get evaporated at the start. In the OP Ring of Fire's case, I guess you can still enjoy it either way with that sexy looking flickering stream of fire. Too bad it's ruined by the fact that it stops shooting, cause it killed the balloons too fast. Jambite, please nerf, I do spy one certain weakness to the tower at least. Alrighty, time to switch on over to the right side, and before anything else, let me just note that for a lot of these 5th tier right side upgrades, there's not going to be any difference between normal and 100 times speed, mostly because certain abilities don't get affected by the attack speed increase. Which makes sense. How exactly do you expect a blade maelstrom to get any stronger with an attack speed buff, since all its power is concentrated on the infinite popping power projectiles, which there are a set amount of? Same thing for the subsequent upgrade called Has Science Gone Too Far, in which the maelstrom vomits out every possible projectile in the game you can think of. Just to show you, here is how the Science Gone Too Far upgrade performs without a boost. I had to pull a worst abilities video and place the maelstrom on the opposite side of the screen to the ZOMG because putting it any closer would one-shot the thing and that ruins the comparison. So yeah, it took somewhere between 3/4 to 100% of the ZOMG health. Now let's see our one tacky boy base boosted, I mean balloon boosted. As for why I decided to send a giant cluster instead of just one, I don't know. Doesn't matter either way, cause we can clearly see the difference between the two, which is absolutely zero. Don't let that one ZOMG popping into BFBs distract you from the fact that it was only because the thing was a hair closer to the tack. I can assure you the boosts, they do nothing. Okay, snipers. Oh yes, it wasn't too long ago that I tried out the OP 7th tier sniper mod, but I think these upgrades are different since these are made by Jammy Boy. Let us have a look at the left side first. I'm too lazy to pull out the description, but just know that the upgrade adds a separate shot to the sniper that only affects up to BFBs, so ZOMGs are excluded. Basically every 10 seconds it launches a ground zero-like explosion that obliterates Moab-class balloons instantly upon impact. That 10 second cooldown is one to point out because we can get that number closer to 0.1 seconds with a hypersonic showcase over here. Now just watch as we see some nuclear explosions occur off stage and also on top of the sniper for some reason, which is probably a visual bug. That and there may be this purple square popping up every now and then, which is also a visual glitch. I guess I had to switch out a certain sprite sheet for this mod or something. So yeah, pretty OP sniper boy. Again, I should be pointing out that this exploding shot can't affect any balloons, as you can see by them just working on by, at least until the sniper shot picks them up. Moving on to the right side, which warning, only contains an ability, so you're in for a real bummer. Oh well, you can still see the ability real soon though, where instead of a supply drop flying in a plane to give you a tiny crate of money, this 5th tier upgrade drops down everything and your mother in one fell swoop. Yeah, quite the drastic change from the 4th tier ability to say the least. As I said earlier about the science has gone too far upgrade though, using monkey boost doesn't affect the number of projectiles nor the popping power, so it's safe to say that we'll be the same for this guy. But just for kicks, let's boost the sniper first then use the ability. As you can see, same number of aces, same number of crates, same number of nuclear pineapples. That should settle it all. Last but not least is the ninja. Fitting statement actually, cause it's the last tower we're showcasing, but certainly not the least, as you'll find out why very soon. The left side 5th tier ninja is called the Shuriken God, and it basically spawns this weird looking pattern around the ninja. An unstoppable pattern to say the least, seeing as how easily it can take down these ZOMGs and its insides down. We already got a giant cluster of Shuriken spinning around it, so I'm kind of scared to see the result when I start dropping a couple of boosts down, because I'm not sure if that also spawns more projectiles. The answer we will find right about now, and from a first glance it does indeed look like it's filling out the remaining gaps. And I can also tell it's doing a bit more damage, but thankfully no noticeable difference when it comes to lag, which if you don't know is my arch enemy. I think we are done here, so at last here is the final hypersonic 5th tier upgrade for today, the Cluster Flash Bomb God. This one doesn't come with an ability, instead it's all pure power, a perfect combination for this video. What you're seeing right now is the Cluster Ninja in its normal state, which is very concerning because that's how much projectiles one tiny bomb can spawn. Now imagine that times 100. Actually, you don't need to imagine it because you can just watch it right now as I begin to go full nuclear war on my CPU. What is about to show up is not slowed down, in case you were wondering. In fact, it's actually sped up considerably, so you should thank me for making the sacrifice just for you guys. I saw this coming from a mile away. At least I can roll the credits while the game is rolling at 0.01 frames per second. This video was written and produced by ISAB, This video cannot be rebroadcasted or uploaded without the express written consent from ISAB, or unless you like, subscribe, share, and leave a positive comment on the video. More to come in the future, so there's also another reason to subscribe. Have a hypersonic fifth tier day.